So, as an introduction to the first part, I wish to stress that the environment, our planet, is very diversified, as you can see in this picture, with a considerable landscape component and a huge variability, not only, of course, in the natural environment, but also in the rest of the environment. And we should also stress that over the past few decades, evidence has mounted that the Earth's environment is changing at an accelerated rate. This map is the map of the anthropic impact of soilscapes that belongs to the 90s, and it is very easy to see the areas that undergo a deep anthropic impact on soilscapes. The darker is the color, the deepest is the footprint of man on soils. And there is also the possibility, if you see the light pollution of the Earth, it is possible to see a perfect overlapping of this map with the map of light pollution of the Earth. Our statistic information shows that the actual environmental change are more rapid and profound than the natural variability in our system, and that such global environmental changes are directly driven by growth in human population and economic development. And growth in human population and economic development induce an accelerating resource consumption, economic activity, and urbanization. This comprises a wide range of changes in the Earth functioning, which are accelerating and interact with each other and other environmental changes, not only at local but also at regional and national scales. And according to recent investigation, there are four major components of environmental change that we can distinguish. First, consider local and global climatic changes, a worldwide decline of biodiversity and biodiversity, and change in atmospheric composition, especially the increase in CO2 concentration, and changes in land use and land cover, and again in biodiversity. If we took into consideration the soil resource of a planetary level, we should consider also, we should take also consideration of the development of the population and its growth in time. And in the first year of the Christian era, we were about 250 million, and in 1000 we were 257 million. In 1650 we became 500 million. So it means that we on the Earth, we double the population on the world Earth in 650 years, but we double again the presence of man on Earth from 500 million to 1,000 million only in 200 years. And again, in 1930, we double again only in 80 years. And we double again only in 45 years. And now we are around 7 billion persons of the Earth. And the estimate say us that we will reach around 10 billion persons on the Earth in 2010. These are estimates. But in any case, it is important to see how is the speed of doubling of the population on the Earth. And of course, this big footprints of man on the earth, on the soil scale, has led to the conversion of natural ecosystem in agricultural ecosystem in 1700, with the farming areas in hectares were about 265 million hectares that became 537 million in 1850, 930 million in 1920, and in 2000 year, the conversion reached around 1360 million of hectares. Of course, deforestation has been the main factor of the conversion of natural ecosystem in agricultural ecosystem. In this table that belonged to the end of 2000, to the end of the last millennia, we can see how in 300 years from 17 to the end of 2000, we have a conversion of forests and woods, of savanna and steppe, of tundra and desert, and we lose an average of 3.9 million hectares of, per year of forests and woods, of 2.3 million hectares a year of savanna and steppe, and 0.09 million hectares per year of tundra and desert. We should also underline the transformation of forest ecosystem in agricultural ecosystem. In the same period, we lose 1.45 million hectares of tropical forest, 1.54 million hectares of temperate forest, and you can read by yourself the other numbers. And this happened in 300 years. Of course, the conversion of vast areas of natural ecosystem in agricultural ecosystem was helped by the invention of the plow, already used in the Roman period and described by the poet Virgil in the first century. This is an original Roman plow of that period. And from then to now, the plow has undergone a deep evolution. And the invention of the internal combustion engine has further facilitated the expansion of agricultural areas. USA, Spain, Italy. So, such consideration accounts for two aspects. The influence of man on soil started when Palermo became a farmer. The influence of man on soil formation evolution is much more deep and intense than we can perceive. Zitong has proposed an index of anthropogenic influence for soil of China from the Middle Age to 2000, given by the following equation. You can read by yourself the meaning of this inside the formula. HI is the index of anthropic influence, and this formula leads to this graph in which there is a big increase of anthropogenic or anthropic soil in China. That is a very a country in which there is a traditional system for agriculture, but you can see till 2000 years. If we consider the main human activities that were and are performed with the soil or on the soil, we can group the anthropogenic processes on soil within six main types. Human-induced change of soil class, human-made diagnostic horizons, human-induced new paramaterials, human-induced deep soil disturbance, human-induced change of landfall, human-induced topsoil changes. So let's have a panorama on the six different human-induced change of the soil as a whole, starting from the first class, human induced changes in soil class. For instance, can be soils that due to irrigation become saline soils. I have a cambric horizon that due to human intervention became a saline horizon, or even if an anthropic horizon. Or can be soils that due to anthropic erosion show the underlying plintic horizon, the cambric horizon that became the plintic horizon. Or clay soils that artificially drying become cambric soils from a clay horizon to plintic horizon. Or albeluvial that due to liming become alluvial. For instance, this is an example of cambric soil covered with 40 cm of sandy soil in 1980 and then plowed till 60-70 cm. And due to irrigation, this became a saline soil. And look over here. In the first horizon, we have an amount, an electrical conductivity of 30 decisiemens per meter. And if we see this graph that refer to this soil, we realize that after 1 year of irrigation, due to anthropic influence, due to irrigation, I have the first horizon, the top soil, that became saline. Because the first 25 centimeter, the first 25, the top soil, became saline. This is the limit. 15 decisiemens per meter of electrical conductivity. But we should also take into consideration the amount of exchangeable sodium percentage, that is much more dangerous than the presence of soluble salt in soils. The same, after 1 year of irrigation, 1 meter of depth of the soil became alkaline with more than 15% of sodium on the exchange complex. And this is linked to the anthropic action on the soils. Other examples of human-induced change of soil class. Clay soil, like this one, that artificially drying and became cambric soil from a BG to a BW horizon. Of course, we should stress that the soil are to be considered as anthropogenic soils even if the morphology is not different from that of natural soils. But they should be considered as anthropogenic soil also. Other class, human-made diagnostic horizon. We can consider two different kinds, two different classes. The timeless addition of organic matter lead to the formation of horizons called, according to the world reference base, I don't know how much are you familiar with the soil classification system, but the addition of organic matter lead to the formation of horizons that are called plagic, or pelvic, or orthic. While irrigation lead to the formation of horizons called irragric, anthropic, or hydragric. Let's have an overview on this. Plagic. Plagic is a mineral horizon of anthropic origin made from the addition of organic matter since medieval time, or even before, year after year, since the Middle Age. These are the main aspects, the main physical and chemical parameter of a plagic horizon. Texture, the presence of artifacts inside, less than 20%, a low value in chroma, very dark, the presence of organic matter, and so on. Plagic, what the meaning? In the German agricultural tradition, plagien indicated a salt of about 40 centimeters per 100 centimeters, about 10 centimeters thick, formed by herb and ether, with a dense root system that was collected with a sort of special iron cutting tool and roller. And the plug-in, this salt roller, was used as a fertilizer bedding in the cowsheds and after to amend the soils. First for the cows and then to amend the soils. Why to amend the soils? Because in the northern area of Europe, soil show very low fertile level. Added to the soil, plug-in allow for the cultivation of rye for many years on sandy soil on low natural fertility. The soil fertility increased considerably, but at the same time suffered death of the soil from which farmers killed the plug-in. But this practice, it seems that is 3,000 years old and reached the maximum of the application in the Middle Age. And over the centuries, year after year, year after year, I wish to underline such aspect. Year after year, during the time, this has led to the formation of a humid topsoil, even 130 centimeter depth, that in German is called as Ash Horizonte. The Netherlands, the same, happened in the same. The difference is that the dimension of the plug, of the plug-in. But anyway, the shift in the removal of the plug-in to allow, of course, the deformation was from 5 to 15 years, and to form 1 hectare of ash, people had to collect plug-ins from 5 to 10 hectares. To have 1 hectare, I had to destroy from 5 to 10 hectares. And year after year, year after year, the application of the plug-in at the expenses of surrounding territories depended on the difference in altitude, even to middle depth, and marked by drought in 1798. But still today, we have the presence of soil with a plagic horizon in several areas of the northern Europe. Some data on the plagic horizon, plagic on Pozzo. The same happened and still happened in Meso and South America, in which we have Terra Preta. This is a plagic horizon also in South America, is called Terra Preta, and you see that presence of organic matter in this kind of soil that was originated by the organic mass derived by human settlement. We have two sub-types of terra preta. It depends from the color, it depends from how the soil is ancient, but we can distinguish terra pretas and terra mulatas, but let me go on. This was the original source, and this is the terra preta. Let me go
with the biochar.
Yeah, with the biochar. Other diagnostic horizon that derives from the addition of organic matter is the teric, anthropogenic mineral horizon made by timeless addition of earthy material, compost, large, and so on and so on and so on. These are the main features of the teric horizon, and this is that became from the plagic. So you can see, you can read the differences. The ortic horizon is an anthropogenic mineral horizon made by prolonged cultivation and fertilization or continuous addition of animal and human parts or other organic residues. Year after year, again I wish to stress this concept, addition of even human dust has happened for the night soils in China. And we have also organic diagnostic horizon that originated from irrigation as irrigric, anthragric, and hydraulic. erratic that originates from sediments present inside the water that I use for irrigation, like in this case. Continuous irrigation that leaves sediments on the soils. Erratic horizon has a uniform structure that a clay decreases with depth, and other features that you can read by yourself. This is the texture of an irrigated anthrosol in China, in which one calculated that with the use of 1,000 millimeter year of water for irrigation are deposited 0.5 millimeter of silty material, and that the organic carbon at the depth of 5 meters date back to the first century. So year after year, I have an increase in the soil depth due to the presence of sediment in the irrigation water. The same happens on the other side of the world, in Peru, for instance. But this is an anthropogenic practice that started 1,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago, when men became farmers in different places of the world, in period in which we do not have smartphone, internet, satellite system, press, and things like that. The anthropic horizon is an anthropogenic mineral horizon consisting of a muddy layer that overlies a plot pan with these features. And China is the area of greater diffusion of soils with anthropic horizon. In particular, in Yangtze, the Yellow River, and Suyang Delta. To use these areas of marsh, farmers are usually digging more depressed areas and accumulate the heads of excavation in the surrounding areas. The more depressed areas are transforming to lakes for fish breeding. The surrounding areas are used for the breeding of the mulberry tree for silkworm. This is a virtuous system where the leaves of the mulberry tree supply the silkworm. The silkworm with their dams feed the fish. The fish feed the man. And this soil covers 1.5 million hectares in the area of the Yellow River. Hydrographic horizon, you see here, this is very red part of the soil profile with some chemical features. In China, I thought more very diffused. Let's go on with human-induced paramaterial. When any material that is mainly mineral, like happened in this picture, the surface, on it begins to act biotic and by abiotic factor of peragenesis. In time, it forms a soil that, depending on the use, can be agricultural or forestry soil, like this one, for instance. This is a soil developed on debris from a sulfur mine and that developed in 70 years, in 1992. Debris from a sulfur mine. These are the main parameter, clay, silt, sand, pH, and so on. And this is the classification of this kind of soil, applic regular soil transportive. Fourth class, human-induced deep soil disturbance refers to soil which have undergone deep working or disturbances of different types. As a consequence, this soil do not show any diagnostic horizon, but only fragments which are arranged in a not understandable order. In soil taxonomy, these are arids. In one reference place, are considered inside the arid soil group. If this is an example, you see the jump in clay around 25, 17, 34, 15, 30, jump in clay presence. You see also the jump in cation exchange capacity around 20, 13, 22, 14, 18. This is a very good example of human-induced deep soil disturbance. Aric rhizosol or Alphix serrare, a soil like this. Five group, human-induced change of landfall. Terracing, for instance, is one of the oldest and most used methods that we know for soil management and conservation. Before the, let me say, invention of the terraces by farmers, people used to cultivate this slope in this way. This is a reconstruction of the in the ethnographic museum in Mexico City. People risked the life to put some maize seeds on very steep slope. But after that, when he thinking about the possibility to organize terraces, of course the situation was even better. Historical evidences show that it has spread to all continents at about the same time. Again, I wish to stress that it happened in a period in which there is no internet, no smartphone, no computer. You see here, several regions when the agriculture developed and when terracing started to be when the slope area started to be converted in terracing, more or less around 3,000 years ago, more or less in every part of the world. Terracing is to break down the slope segment to provide a better condition for management of agriculture, sensu lato. You see general effect of terracing in upland and hilly areas, and here in irrigated areas. You can read by yourself the differences from upland and hilly areas and irrigated areas, the differences in the soil features. One of the most known and at the same time answered example in the Canyon del Colca in Peru, it is the deepest canyon of the world. And these terraces belong to the Inca period and still are in use. An example in Oman or in Spain, in which the main features is the possibility to increase the available water capacity, 120 millimeter, 110, 90 millimeter on the top of the lockdown and in soil that are terraced. And finally, the sixth group, human-induced topsoil changes. The most common form of anthropogenic modification concerns the topsoil. Changes in the topsoil have accompanied the pollution of man in its link with the soil, and for this reason have been neglected because they were and still are called normal, normal soil management. Example, liming, fertilization, irrigation that after 1,000, 2,000 years we produce soil for with irrigation or bar beating and things like that. This means that although the topsoil is the most reactive and dynamic actor of the soil, the pedogenetic and the taxonomic survey give more consideration to the topsoil subsoil because it shows natural features. This means also that other activities that have a strong impact on the topsoil are not considered. Contamination, pollution with heavy mineral, acid deposition, xenobiotics, and things like that do not find the right consideration. And again, we have anthropic landscape. So, we have a very fast, let me say, a panorama of these six different classes of human-induced change in the soil that take into consideration soil class, horizon, paramaterial, and so on and so on and so on. And that allow us to realize that main soil forming are man and time. Main soil forming processes are, as I stressed them, centuries long, year after year, recurrent monomanagement practices, for example, intensive fertilization with organic matter, as in the plant game, continual application of earthy material, irrigation with sediment-rich water, well cultivation, things like that. But what happens if in the farm management practices the anthropogenic soil forming actions are few months or even few weeks long instead of centuries or millennia? What about the features and the classification of a soil like this in such cases, in few weeks or in few days? And what about the environmental problems linked to the man's action in a very short period of time? Let's give an answer to this question in the second part of the presentation.